The co-founder of a popular and influential student, like young Republican pro-Trump group, this is Students for Trump, was arrested and charged with assault last week. Here is a picture of Ryan Fournier, 27-year-old who helped launch Students for Trump, accused of grabbing a woman's arm and striking her in the forehead with a firearm, which is just such a horrific phrase to have to read. And to know that a person that had political influence, and as you saw in that picture, was meeting with the president, is alleged to have done. Now, these are allegations. He has not been convicted of this. So let's bear that in mind as we go forward and analyze this. But as of right now, he faces two misdemeanor charges: domestic assault on a female and assault with a deadly weapon. Has been released on a $2,500 bond and is scheduled to appear in court on the 18th of December. So we don't have to wait too long for that. As I said, he did help launch Students for Trump with another guy who also was found guilty of impersonating a lawyer. So a little bit of a suits tie in there. But anyway, right now he leads the group Radical Alert, which aims to expose, quote, radicals and their hate, which has taken over American college campuses. And that is the true thing that is dragging down America. It's radical hate, not pistol whipping your domestic partner, allegedly. Francesca, what do you think?
Yeah, radical hate. I'm sure they're going after the racist who shot three Palestinian American boys in Vermont over Thanksgiving weekend, who called himself a radical, right? Radical patriot. Is that the kind of? Oh no, but he's got patriot in there. Okay. Oh, it's for your team. Oh, okay. Shooting Arabs is fine. I mean, it's just, yeah. This is par for the course. This is what it is. And again, if there are Republican women listening, this is your party. Honestly, I don't believe that, like, I don't want to like Nancy Pelosi whisper to the good Republicans, but I do think that like women who are conservative should really attempt to understand what Christian nationalism means for them. It means total control over their own bodies in terms of reproductive rights, but it also means being secondary to your partner, to your spouse, being struck with a gun, being threatened, jeez, being brutalized. It means being Steven Crowder's wife, right? I mean, thank God she got out of that. It means being berated when you're, however, 8 months pregnant with twins. I mean, this is that sort of Western male chauvinism that within it not only has a lot of anti-Semitism, a lot of Islamophobia and racism, a lot of xenophobia against immigrants, and most fundamentally misogyny and sexism. And this is part of MAGA ideology. So are we okay with that? Because I'm not.
Yeah. I'm so glad that you pointed that out, because look, again, allegations, bear that in mind for everything that we say, but we know what the right is and we know what they think about women. We do. You can't deny it. I know that there are some women, as you point out, there are female conservatives, there are female Republicans or whatever, there are female influencers who preach like willful, voluntary female subjugation. And they're making bank off of telling women that they should date guys like this and get pistol whipped in the forehead, allegedly.
Yes.
And the men present it, like they draw other men in by presenting this as like strength. This is the weakest, most pathetic, whiny. I saw that Crowder thing. Like this is supposed to be alpha. This is supposed to be strength. This is so utter. This is worms crawling in the dirt who are so weak that they have to control through force of law everyone else, so they have some chance of appearing authoritative and strong. And I'm just going to throw out a couple of tweets. I just did a little bit of searching, because you know, if you are the sort of person to allegedly pistol whip someone with a gun, you've probably given your thoughts about guns in the past. So Ryan had previously tweeted his thoughts about, oh, Alec Baldwin doesn't know about gun safety. Everybody's having fun with that tragedy. Gun safety is just pistol whipping the people nearby you, allegedly, not shooting them. Had also had a tweet about paying cash for firearms so that you won't be caught up in invasive tracking systems. So that's not scary at all now with these allegations out there. Had previously tweeted, guns empower law-abiding people. Gun laws empower criminals. Yep, everyone with a gun is just law abiding. They don't do anything wrong. They don't hurt anyone. They don't potentially kill anyone or anything like that. And had, as everyone does, bragged about being a law abiding gun owner. Yeah, every gun owner is responsible and law abiding until they're not. until they make a mistake and accidentally shoot someone or purposefully shoot someone or hurt someone. Now, in this case, he's not alleged to have shot someone, but we have done so many stories like this, and there's always commentary like that lurking in the background. Anyway, we'll find out the next step in a couple of weeks. Stay tuned. Again, allegations. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.